Thank you. What's he doing up here?
Don't know.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Our Lady of Lourdes. Thank you for your cooperation in making our celebration safe for all. Today we celebrate the feast of the most holy body and blood of Christ. The presider for this liturgy is our pastor, Father Scott Wimsett. Our gathering song is You Are the Voice. Please stand as we begin our celebration.
Son and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship and strength of the Holy Spirit be with you all. As we gather on this festive day to give God thanks and praise, we begin by admitting that we are sinners. At the times we've sinned, let us ask now for God's forgiveness and mercy. Thank you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption. Who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all of your journeying in the desert, so as to test you by affliction and find out whether or not it was your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be afflicted with hunger and then fed you with manna, a food unknown to you and your fathers, in order to show you that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of the Lord. Do not forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert with its seraph serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought you forth water for you from the flinty rock and fed you in the desert with manna, a food unknown to your fathers." The word of the Lord.
Thank you, God.
Thank you. speak of your might, O Lord, the glory of your kingdom. Faithful in word and deed, and always near, his name is holy, lifting up all those who fall. God raises up the lowly. I will praise your name, my King and my God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the cup of blessing that we bless, it is not a participation in the blood of Christ. The bread that we break is not a participation in the body of Christ. Because the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are of one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jewish crowds, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you.
Table. And our moments of tension,
celebrate a birthday. You know, if you want a strawberry cake, the love goes into it to make it happen. Even though it's not what you might want, you know, it's what we do. Or maybe something else. And today, as we celebrate the feast of the body and blood of Christ, it's all about God's love for us that we gather around the table of the Lord over and over again. And we hear the powerful stories in Scripture. You know, we're reminded why we celebrate what we do, why the people were led out of slavery in the first place, to be an image of God's holy people, and to worship Him in freedom with God.
Knowing that when one part of the body is not well, the whole body is not well. We ask these prayers for each other and our world.
Our response is, loving God, hear our prayer. For the church, that we may continue to be stirred by the Holy Spirit, to be open to how our hearts might be moved, and be courageous to act as Jesus would. We pray. For leaders, that they may listen with an open heart, act wisely in response to public outcry, and place the needs of all people first, we pray. For each of us, that we may encounter the vulnerable with compassion, hear stories from our LGBTQ, Black, and immigrant neighbors, and treat everyone with dignity, we pray. For all families who are separated, for those in hospitals and nursing homes, and for those recovering from illness, we pray. For this community, that we may hear God's voice in one another and be willing to build a table in our community where all may sit and dine in the Lord's banquet, we pray.
Loving God, through the holy bread and wine of the Eucharist, we know that your Son remains with us always. Help us receive in that nourishment a renewed spirit to be Christ-like for the world. As always, we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, your mighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, with the praise of the Lord and the Lord, for our good and the cause of the Church.
Grant your Church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings we here present. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With
lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful by this sacred mystery, you make them holy, so that the human race bound by one world may be enlightened by one faith and united by one bond of charity. And so we approach the table of this wondrous sacrament, so that bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song of adoration, and we, with all the host of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth,
holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. When we eat this bread and drink this cup,
for as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
With King King and power, and glory.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. If you're in a pew with your children, like husband and wife, share the sign of peace. If not, just give the sign of peace from a distance. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
Because the loaf of bread is one, so are we part of that one loaf. May we see in each of us, no matter the differences on the outside, the richness that makes us one. Let's pray together. Our parish is composed of people like me. I help make it what it is. It will be holy if I am. Its pews will be filled if I help fill them. It will be prayerful if I pray. It will make generous gifts to many causes if I am a generous giver. It will bring others into its worship if I invite and bring them. It will be a parish of loyalty and love, of fearlessness and faith, of compassion, charity, and mercy, if I make it what it is and fill it with these same things. Therefore, with the help of God, I shall dedicate myself to the task of being all the things that I want our parish to be. Amen. There is a basket on the table in the back for your offering. Also, please remember that we will exit the church from the rear pews first.
And just one other minor announcement. Last Sunday at this Mass, we had a visitor in clerics seated over in this section. I am supervising a seminary student for the summer. He is working at Baptist Health. As a matter of fact, we crossed paths this morning. He had an emergency call. So his name is Dustin Hungerford. If you went to Sacred Heart Academy, he may have taught you a few years ago. So just know you may see Dustin in and out. And one Sunday he has to preach. I've already told him that. So welcome him to the parish if you see him around, please. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, love, and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please join us in singing Build Us a Table.
Boundaries and keep us apart. Walls keep the world from our eyes and our heart. Tables are round, making room for one more. Welcoming friends we had not known before. So build us a table and tear down the wall. Christ is our host, there is room for us all. Is our host, there is room for us all.
us safe from all question and doubt. But at a table in open exchange, new ties are formed as our lives rearrange. So build us a table and tear down the wall. Christ is our host, there is room for us all. Build us a table and tear down the wall. Christ is our host, there is room for us all. Once we were strangers, divided alone, hate and distrust built a wall stone by stone. Now at a table, the bread that we share joins us to Christ in a circle of care. So build us a table and tear down the wall. Christ is our host, there is room for us all. Build us a table and tear down the wall. Christ is our host, there is room for us all.